with your host, Ed McMahon. Tonight, the search continues for the best new stars of the year on their way to $1.5 million in winnings with last week's returning dance champions, The Boys Club. Junior vocalist champion, Countess Vaughn. Comedy champion, Mike Dugan. Female vocalist champion, Christina Nichols. Teen dance champion, Keith DiOrio. Male vocalist champion, Victor Cook. And TV spokesmodel champion, Cynthia Gal. All going for the title, Best New Star of 1988 in the world's greatest talent competition.
In certain categories, the semifinal spots are already filled, so they'll compete to return as champions next season. One of those confirmed semifinalist spots is held by our returning dance champions. They've won four in a row, and tonight they go for win number five. From Los Angeles, welcome Boys Club. Thank you, Boys Club. Your challenges come to us from the exciting cities of Honolulu, Hawaii, and Limoges, France. Please give a Star Search welcome to Frenchie and James. Thank you, Frenchie and James. Great stuff, dancers. Now the judges will give us a winner. Boys Club received 3.5 stars. Frenchie and James received 3.25 stars. Boys Club. Congratulations. It's getting to be a habit. You're already in the semifinals. How long have you been dancing together?
Oh, about 2 weeks before 10 days ago, which is about a month.
Are you kidding me? Are you for real? 1 month and you got that routine down like that? That's wonderful. Well, you deserve to be champions. We're going to see you in the semifinals next week.
Thank you.
Great job, guys.
Next week, in the semifinals in the dance competition, Artie and Sharon compete against the Boys Club. More confirmations tonight on Star Search 88, The Great Entertainer.
The talent has never been better than on Star Search 88, and I think you'll agree, particularly with the junior vocalists. One of our confirmed semifinalists is 6-year-old Gerard Spector. He's here tonight. Would you please stand up? Gerard, look at the size of this guy, and he's a talent, a champion. Oh. He'll compete with our current champion. She goes for win number 4. Welcome 9-year-old Countess Vaughn. Thank you, Countess. The judges, as usual, vote on a scale of 1 to 4 for being best. The little challenger has a big voice. She's from Westerly, Rhode Island. Here's 10-year-old Cheyenne.
I want to dedicate this to all you women out there, so I'm sure you'll all stand by your man. Sometimes it's hard to be a woman, giving all your love to just one man. Stand by your man, give him 2 arms to cling to, and something warm to come to when nights are cold. Hello.
Big talent from our little singers tonight. As the judges vote, let's talk to them. Okay, you wrote a letter to our producer, said you were very, very happy to be on Star Search, but also you're very happy to be in California. Tell us about that.
I think they have a lot of nice people in L.A.
About says it all, doesn't it? And Cheyenne, you've got a very distinctive sound for a young lady. When did you start singing like that?
Well, actually, I started singing at the age of 2, but professionally, at age 7, I went to musical theater. But you see, in musical theater, they don't have enough parts for children in the East Coast, so I decided to go into music. I chose country music because country music comes from the heart.
You know, there are times when I just want to get out of the business. All right, the judge will vote. We'll see which of these two talented young ones is our champion. Junior champion Countess Vaughn receives 4 stars. Challenger Cheyenne receives 3 stars. Countess Vaughn. All right, Countess, that means you're going to go against that young man right there, Gerard Spector, okay? In the semifinals next week. We'll see you then. Congratulations. The qualities they are judged on are beauty, poise, and the ability to speak effectively, they being the TV spokesmodels. In the semifinals are Laurie Dickerson and this gorgeous young lady. She's from Los Angeles, California, with 3 wins, wears a fashion design by Jeran. Here's Cynthia Gao. Hi, Cynthia. Welcome back to Star Search. Tell us what's coming up in the next 2 weeks here on Star Search.
Well, it's very exciting. This season has wound up to a really nice little excitement and anticipation at the very end. Next week, we're going to the semifinals, right, which I'll be competing in. Right. And the week after that is whoever wins the semifinals, which is, of course, the finals. And we're all keeping our fingers crossed.
Okay, good luck. Here she is in her very latest Star Search fashion video, right up here. See your challenger in a little while. What's happening next?
Spuds McKenzie, watch out. Here comes Winston the Wonder Dog. Next on The Search, Star Search 88.
Let's move to next door. Could I borrow a Diet Pepsi?
Sure. Yes.
Be right with you.
When you go all out for taste, the taste to go out for is Diet Pepsi.
Here's a Diet Pepsi.
Thanks. I hope it wasn't too much trouble.
No trouble at all.
Diet Pepsi, the choice of a new generation.
Time for us to bring a little laughter and mirth into your living rooms with the comedy competition. This category is full for the semifinals next week. There's Michael Finney and our current champion. He's seeking his 3rd victory tonight from San Francisco. Here's Mike Dugan.
Hi, it's always good to be back here. This is my 3rd time. It's nice to be here. I was in down south for the last 3 days. I can't really say where, but Dukes of Hazzard was on PBS there. And evidently they call it a documentary. Who's to say? I passed this hitchhiker. You ever pass a hitchhiker who's like so weird looking that you know no one's ever going to pick this guy up? They're cutting the grass around him. He's got a little sign out that says, "Your house." When I was 18, 19, I hitchhiked all over the country. Cars would pass me by, and I swore, boy, when I grow up and I get a car, I'm going to pick up every hitchhiker. Well, guess what, folks? I'm growing up now, and I got a car, and there's no way in hell. I got better things to do than play host to a mass murderer, I'll tell you that much. Well, it's nice to be here performing in front of you people because I perform at nightclubs a lot, and people are drinking, and I don't drink myself. I get horrible hangovers. I've got this theory about hangovers that not only does drinking kill brain cells, the ones that survive spend the whole next day at the wake. It's a disaster. I expect to see little brain cell newspaper headlines. Thousands perish as black Russians invade cerebellum.
Anyway.
I had this one friend in high school, every time he partied, he'd try to tell you these car crash stories with supernatural overtones. You want to hear something really, really wild, man? I had this friend Jimmy, left the party, was heading down the mountain to get some more beer, went around the bend, missed a turn, went off into the ravine, they didn't find his car for 2 days. Get this, dude. Stairway to Heaven was still playing on the tape deck. Everything hits you harder when you're a teenager, though, doesn't it? Remember breaking up with your first love, puppy love, how painful that was? Did you ever do this? You don't even know why. Right after you break up, you're heartbroken. You just drive by their house late at night and look over. Like they're going to come out at 2:30 in the morning and marry you or something. I drove by my first girlfriend's house every night for a month. I'm down to about once a week now. And her kids stand on the driveway and wave. Thank you very much. Good night.
Thank you, Mike. Your challenge is from Tacoma, Washington. He's a former pilot flight instructor who decided to take a chance at comedy. Here's his star search opportunity. Welcome, Earl Burks.
He said Spud McKenzie's a sissy.
Come on, let's go to work, buddy.
Be nice. Watch it. It's slippery. You're okay. Hey, Winston the Wonder Dog, ladies and gentlemen, Winston the Wonder Dog. Can you sit down? Sit down. Here. That's okay. Relax. Oh, listen. You want to go ahead and do the show yourself? All right. This is Winston the Wonder Dog, ladies and gentlemen. Not a great frisbee dog. Like I said that. Not a great frisbee dog. Like you throw the frisbee, this dog runs into a tree like. He'll lay on top of the frisbee for a couple of hours and he'll go, I've got you now. Oh, you're excited to be here. Winston and I play Trivial Pursuit. Do you play this game at home? This is a lot of fun. Watch this. Okay, look. Can you see the card at all? Okay. I'm just kidding. It was a joke. Okay, here we go. I'm going to ask you these questions and I want you to think about the answers. Think about the answers now. Just don't blurt them out. The outer surface of a tree is called a what? Think now. Come on, think. Bark, bark, right, okay. What's on top of a house? Think about roof, roof, right. How do we like our women? Rough, rough, all right. No, wait a minute, how do we like to be kissed? Woo! Woo! Now, Winston doesn't play Trivial Pursuit, ladies and gentlemen. Winston does famous impressions. This is Winston's impression of Stevie Wonder. No New Year's Day. Sammy Davis Jr., who can make the sunshine, cover it with dew. Winston's been watching Sesame Street a little bit too much lately. Remember this chick from Gone with the Wind? I don't know nothing about birthing no babies. This is Winston's impression of a California driver. Hey, your blinker's on, you idiot! Your blinker's on! And of course, the flying nun, Sister Batril! Sister Batril! Thank you very much. You've been great. Good night. Come on, come on.
Thank you, Earl and Winston. Our comedian's done a terrific job again. Now let's see what the judges have to say. They give champion Mike Dugan 2¾ stars. His challenger Earl Burks receives 3¼ stars. Earl Burks. Come on over, Mike. Mike, come on over. Come on, Earl. Earl, congratulations. You'll be our returning champion next season. You and Winston. Hi, Winston. How you doing? All right. He finds out who I work for, he'll be nicer. All right, we'll see you on the semifinals next week.
Thanks.
Okay, Mike, thank you, and good luck to you. Thank you very much. Okay, Cynthia.
For the past 11 weeks, champs and challengers have been competing to make it to the round 2 semifinals next week to get one step closer to the $100,000 finals. Round 2 winners will meet these round 1 winners.
One step closer to stardom, male vocalist Barry Fish. Going for best junior star, America's Apple Pie. For TV spokesmodel Sophia Bowen. Going for best comedian Al LaBelle. For female vocalist Linda Etter. Going for $100,000 in dance Tony and Carrie. And for best teen star of 88, Raquel Herring. You're 2 weeks away from the $100,000 finals.
More round two semifinals will be confirmed tonight. Next, the female vocalist and teens on the search. Star Search 88.
Week. It's the round two semifinals. Cecile goes up against the winners of round one in the $100,000 finals. Those finals are just 2 weeks away. Now, there's a whole lot of Star Search excitement here, and looking at those semifinals in the female vocalist category are already confirmed champions, Dee Dee Belson and Mary Daly. Tonight's returning champion hopes to continue the winning streak to appear next season. From Placerville, California, welcome Christina Nichols.
I saw an old friend of ours today. She asked me about you. I didn't quite know what to say. Seems you've been making the rounds round here. While I've been trying to make tears disappear. Now I'm almost over.
Christina, her challenger originally comes from New Jersey. She now lives in Philadelphia, where she watches Star Search on WPHL. We're glad she joins our talented Star Search roster tonight. Welcome, Laura Mann. Thank you, Laura. Let's get a decision on these two great performances. Champion Christina Nichols receives 2 3/4 stars. Challenger Laura Mann gets 3 stars. Laura Mann. Congratulations, Laura. What that means is you'll be our returning champion next year. We'll see you then, okay? Thank you. Good night.
The semifinals and the $100,000 finals get closer and the competition gets hotter. Next, Teen Dancers. This is Star Search 88.
Now, one of our spokesmodel discoveries from last year, Julie McCullough, has been very busy since her appearance on Star Search. Let's take a look.
Just did the First and Ten show, and I just got 2 national commercials. I'm happy.
We got the picture!
There's only one camera system you can buy that lets you hold the picture in your hand while you still hold the feeling in your heart.
Since Star Search, Julie McCullough had a feature role in the HBO series First and Ten, Going for Broke.
And I play kind of a vampy, not so nice girl on it. I dump this poor guy and for a football player, and I wind up dumping the football player and going back to the other guy.
It's over between us, Billy. Stuart's much more interesting than you are. So after doing the Star Search show, I was submitted by my Star Search tape, along with a few other girls, to Who's the Boss. They needed a blonde, and so we all went in, auditioned, and I got it. And that was it.
Hi, Mona. You coming to aerobics class? Bring your friend, too.
In little more than a year's time, Julie has gone from Star Search to feature films.
It's called Big Bad Mama 2. It's Angie Dick, it's my player daughter. We're like sort of 1930s gangsters.
I figure we got close to $1,000, Mama.
Yeah, Crawford owes us a lot more than that.
What he did to Daddy?
What he's doing to everybody, darling.
I had a great time in Star Search.
That's wonderful. Continued success to Julie McCullough. Time to meet another special and beautiful lady. Earlier, I had the chance to meet spokesmodel champion Cynthia Gao. Here now is her challenger for the title. She's from Toronto, wearing a fashion designed by Claire's Collections. Here's Rhonda D'Amore. Hi, Rhonda. Welcome to your Star Search. You're our second spokesmodel to come from Toronto. Is there a lot of modeling going on up there?
Yes, we have 2 fashion magazines, as well as a lot of commercials and catalog work.
Besides modeling, what are some of your other loves?
Well, I like to cook, but when I really want to relax, I enjoy creating my own designs with sequins and rhinestones on clothing.
Very good. All right, Rhonda, we're going to see you now in your very first fashion video, Rhonda D'Amore, right up here. Very nice. Decision time a little later on. What's coming up next?
Next, we have the teens, and Victor Cook goes for win number 8 as the world's greatest talent competition takes the next step toward the $100,000 finals.
This is the moment for the teen dancers to be showcased. In the semifinals are the Duane dancers. They're in our audience tonight. Would you please stand up, these lovely ladies? Take a bow. The Duane dancers. They and our current champ will compete in 1 week's time for the $10,000 teen category grand prize. From Brooklyn, New York, his 17-year-old Keith DiOrio. The teen dance challenges are 13, 15, and 16, respectively. They are Megan, Lonnie, and Desiree. TNT. I'll talk with the teens and the judges will vote. Okay, looking good out there. Let me find out. You're in the semifinals next week. Where do you hope your winnings and your exposure on this show will take you?
Well, I hope to have a very successful career on Broadway.
On Broadway, all right. Now, this is TNT. TNT, introduce yourselves.
I'm Megan Bywater, 13.
Lonnie Haynes, 15.
Desiree Robbins, 16.
All right, let's find out who the winner is going to be. The teen champion, Keith DiOrio, gets 4 stars. The challengers, TNT, receive 3 stars. Keith DiOrio is the champion. Congratulations, Keith. We'll see you next week in the semifinals. Okay. Rhonda.
The round 2 semifinals are next week. The competition comes to a close tonight to get ready for the big event.
Next week in Teen Dance, Keith DiOrio goes against the Dwayne Dancers. For male vocalist is Jimbo Henson up against Victor Cook. For female vocalist, Dee Dee Belson against Mary Daly. In dance, it's Artie and Sharon against the Boys Club. For TV spokesmodel, Cynthia Gow facing Laurie Dickerson. In comedy, Michael Finney matches wits with Mike Dugan. And for junior vocalist, Countess Vaughn competes with Jared Spector. Next week, it's the round 2 semifinal.
Those are some of the talented performers that will have a shot at $100,000 in each category. Next, Victor Cook goes for win number 8 on Star Search 88.
Tonight's male vocalist. In next week's semifinals, we already have Jimbo Henson and the present champion. He came to us 7 weeks ago from Brooklyn, New York. Will he make it 8 in a row tonight? Here's Victor Cook.
Here I stand, not knowing what the future holds. Taking a chance and following my soul. Doing what I must do to make my dreams come true. I can make it, no matter what people say. I can make it, no matter what comes my way. Success is mine for the taking. I can see new horizons awakening. I can make it. So many roads, but there's one I must choose, and as I go, my faith will see me through. I'm reaching for the sky with my head held high. I can make it, no matter what people say. I can make it, no matter what comes my way. I'm following my soul. I'm reaching for my goal. Come with me, I'm going home.
Victor, to challenge in the male vocalist category, we have a rising singing star from San Francisco. He's a video DJ who writes great music as well. A Star Search hello to Gil Zanuga.
Face to face, my reflection in your eyes. I was scared to say too much. Staring at my shoes, feeling so confused. Shot down without a gun, victim of a hit and a run. Won't you come? There's a message here for you. No need to read between the lines. I am inside out. There can be no doubt. I want you and no one else. Please identify yourself.
Fine performances from our male vocalists tonight. Judges, give us a champion. Victor Cook receives 4 stars. Challenger Gil Zuniga receives 3 stars. Victor Cook. Congratulations. once again, Victor. That is the all-time high in wins for this season. Now, you told us a few weeks ago that you have 11 brothers and sisters. Tell us about your family.
Well, I have 8 brothers and I have 3 sisters.
Now, do any of them sing?
11 of us out of 12.
Is that what, girl or boy doesn't sing?
A boy.
A boy, okay. We'll get him started next year. I understand you're also in a Broadway show, is that right?
Yes, a new Broadway gospel show called Don't Get God Started. And it's a gospel revival on stage.
Terrific. We'll see you next week in the semifinals. Victor Cook, congratulations once again. This is it, our last competition of the regular season before we continue to the big money. Judges, you've seen them, you've heard them. What's the decision? Will it be champion Cynthia Gao or her challenger Rhonda D'Amore? The judges give champion Cynthia Gao 3.25 stars. Her challenger Rhonda D'Amore receives 2.5 stars. Cynthia Gao is our champion. Nice job, Cynthia. Your 4th win. We'll see you right here next week in the semifinals. Now, stay with me. We'll be right back with all of tonight's champions. We're counting the days to the $100,000 finals right after this. Stars were found again here tonight and a great show to finish up round 2 competition. Next week, it's the round 2 semifinals. Here's who you'll see in competition.
For male vocalist, Victor Cook squares off with Jimbo Henson. In teen dance, Keith DiOrio against the Dwayne Dancers. In comedy, Mike Dugan matches wits with Michael Finney. For female vocalist, Dee Dee Belson against Mary Daly. For dance, Artie and Sharon go head-to-head with the Boys Club. For junior vocalist, Jared Spector meets Countess Vaughn. And for TV spokesmodel, Laurie Dickerson faces Cynthia Gao.
After the semifinals, we move on to the $100,000 finals. You'll be part of all this excitement as we continue to hand out over $1.5 million. Some of our champions tonight will return next season. Good night from Star Search 88, the world's greatest talent competition. See you next week on round 2 semifinals.